You know, I'm sometimes asked about Freemasonry and the Masons, and I'm sometimes told that this leader, that leader's a Mason, and that the Masons are responsible for all kinds of evil around the world. And if you believe Hamas terrorists, that the Jews are behind Freemasonry. You know, I hear lots of things about the Masons, but I am not an expert on Masonry. I don't have close friends who were part of the Masons. But the question is, can you be a true and committed Mason and follow Jesus as Lord at the same time? Let me present to you Luke chapter 14, verse 33. This is something Jesus lays out plainly as a requirement for all. He says this, and this is at the end of a teaching. So therefore, any of you who does not renounce all that he has cannot be my disciple. Now you say, well, hang on. If you're married, does that mean you renounce your wife, your husband? If you're married, does that mean, and you have children, that you renounce your children? If you work at a job, does that mean you renounce your job? No, here's what it's saying. That first, in order to follow Jesus, you have to say, I'm yours. I'm yours, no preconditions. For example, I'm in medical school, and I'm going to be a medical doctor, but Lord, whatever you want, if you want me to be a missionary or a preacher, I'll do whatever you want me to do. All right, whatever it is, you're a musician and that's your career. You lay down your life before Jesus, even if music itself and the music you play is fine and it's beautiful. You say, Lord, whatever you want, I'll lay down the violin. I'll lay down the piano, whatever you want. Here I am. Use me to the full. That's the attitude we all have to have. If we know something is sinful, of course. For me, shooting heroin, following Jesus, I understood those weren't compatible. Getting drunk, following Jesus, I understood those weren't compatible. Being hateful and ugly towards other people, following Jesus, I understood those weren't compatible. But my whole life was given over to the Lord in the end of 1971. Lord, whatever it takes, whatever you want, here I am. I'm your son. I'm your servant. Use me. I've died to my life and I live to do your will. But specifically, when it comes to something like Masonry, there would be a dual loyalty. There would be a competing loyalty. There would be a loyalty to another brotherhood, to another fraternity, to other principles, and to other truths that were contrary to the gospel or very different than the gospel, and you would be called to follow those. So, if you're a Mason and you've been committed to Masonry and this is a big part of your identity and you come to follow Jesus, you're going to have to lay that at the foot of the cross. And then you see everything in Masonry that's contrary to the gospel, all the more do you leave it behind and say, Lord, I'm your servant and your servant alone.